that coming up. But in just a moment, we're going to patch a phone call through to Graeham Goble from Little River Band.
Oh, oh. Yeah. And quite a few other acts as well. He and Beeb Birtles had a huge hit. Did a little song called Daddy Cool. Did a few other things, but we'll talk Little River Band.
Did he do this song as well?
He wrote it, my friend.
What a song.
Take a listen to LRB or Little River Band. This is Reminiscing. Graeham Goble from that band in just a moment. A person that we have been dying to speak to. Laurel, Gary and Mark, 882 4BC. The good times just got better. Laurel, Gary and Mark, 882 4BC. What a pretty song from LRB or Little River Band, I should say. That is Reminiscing at 12 past 7.
We love an Australian success story. I mean, who doesn't?
Who doesn't?
Oh.
And one of the most successful would have to be Little River Band.
Yeah.
I mean, not many Australian bands have totally conquered America.
Yeah.
These guys did.
And I think when you're watching Countdown, you know, back in the day, and you see a band on there and you go, wow, they're good, they're so great. And this very day, you will hear a Little River Band song on the radio. That shows how good they are.
Well, there's some great news for LRB fans, and we're going to tell you all about it with the man from LRB, Mr. Graeham Goble.
Yay! Hello.
Graeham, wow, this is just such a great thrill. I must admit, I was in Nashville about, 15 years ago, and I'm flicking through the CDs in a Nashville record store, and there it was, a whole section on Little River Band. And it dawned on me, I don't think a lot of people in Australia realised how globally successful Little River Band is.
No, you're absolutely right. I mean, even though we did have a great amount of success in Australia, America was certainly where it just exploded. And I think the difference between the Australian and the American market is that Americans just don't forget. Australians tend to forget. And so when you go to America, it's not surprising that you would find all of our product there in the record stores.
I mentioned, Graeham, earlier that there's wonderful news for LRB fans. What is it?
We've got a new Ultimate Hits and a companion volume called Masterpieces. There's a total of 51 songs, and they've all been remastered, gone back to the best source, and it's the best sounding Little River Band releases ever. And so on the one volume, we've got all of the singles that were ever released all around the world. And on the second volume, we've got all of the deep cuts, the favourite tracks of fans that weren't singles, are now on a separate volume called Masterpieces. And they include some things that have never, ever been heard before. Like there's a couple of wonderful recordings of when we performed in 1983 with John Farnham, and we did with an orchestra a song called Love Letters, which is just like amazing. That's never been out before, and we took the opportunity to remix a couple of things, but they're all just sounding pristine, and you'll be amazed. I don't know if you've heard them yet.
Will we be hearing the wonderful performance from the band at Brisbane Expo?
Not that one, because we don't have the tapes to that. It's something that could be done. It's just that they are in the archives. See, these things, they cost a lot of money to get out of the archives and then mix them and, you know, all of that. There's a lot of work involved, and that's why this particular project has taken many years to come to fruition.
I love it when I listen to a vinyl in particular. It's that beautiful, warm sound, which I've got Diamantina Cocktail on vinyl, which I play over and over again and have to flip it over and over again. I do love it. I guess it's the vocals and the harmonies that really catch me. I mean, you've got great vocal bands of the world like the Eagles, you know, and you guys are in that group of great vocals. Did you guys used to like really practice that, or was it just a natural click of voices?
It was a natural blend of voices, but prior to LRB, when I used to flat with Beeb, we used to do a lot of practice together. We'd spend endless hours just with acoustic guitars harmonizing, and I think, you know, we developed a blend and a harmony singing, you know, really pretty close to what the Everly Brothers were able to achieve. And Lennon and McCartney, that was with Beeb and I. And then when we added Glenn, it was a very natural thing.
How did that harmony balance change when Farnham took over? Or did it change at all?
It went to another level. It went up an inversion because John's a higher singer than Glenn. Like I was writing songs specifically for John's voice. So those songs couldn't have been done. I did love the way that John sang Cool Change when he was in the band. I thought he sang it differently to Glenn. We did it in a higher key. And the songs that Glenn sang for the band, they're the definitive versions. I mean, no one sings Reminiscing like Glenn. And a song like Mistress of Mine, I think, is my favourite vocal of Glenn's. So as a writer, when I had John, I could write songs like We Two, which is one of my favourite LRB songs. I couldn't have written for with Glenn because it was a different key and a different melody. It's just you work with what you've got, and they were the times when whatever members were in the band, that's what I was writing for.
Well, ultimate hits and masterpieces, they're available right now on a 3LP vinyl set. Oh, thank you, Graeham. And the 2CD digital formats. It's been an absolute pleasure chatting to you, Graeham Goble of Little River Band. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much. Lovely to talk.
The good times just got better. Laurel, Gary and Mark on 882 4BC. That is Billy Joel and Uptown Girl. It is 20... 20-